Oh shit, I can feel the heat. Oh snap, that's hot. Oh my god, get the car out of there. Get the car out! Save the car! Get the car! Oh shit, now the wind is fucking kicking up. The car's gonna go. Save the cars! The car! Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh man! Oh my god! That's where my children, my grandchildren, go on the bus. I mean, that's the corner right there. Oh my god! Oh, the house, you can see it's melting. I don't know if you guys can catch it. Let me see if I can go in a little bit. Oh, that's not good because it blocks. Yeah, that's probably a little better. Oh, no. Oh, my. So sad. Look at that. It's just a total loss. All they can do is try to save stuff on the outside. You know, today's Tuesday, election day. For the whole weekend, maybe Friday, Saturday, Sunday, into yesterday morning, it was really warm. I mean, we're talking 60s and 70s outside. This is November. And today it got cold. I mean, I don't know if that had anything to do with it. Oh, I heard that. Oh my god, it's so, oh, you can see inside the, I don't think you can see, let me see if I can get a little closer into that doorway, you can kind of see the stairwell as it's going up. Oh, the cops just went by, the fire department's not even here yet. Oh shit, that was loud, that car's gonna go, I feel bad. Fuck, can you hear that? I wonder what the fuck that is. Here's the other thing. There's every chance in the world they've got a tank of oil. Oh shit, you know what? I wonder if the next door neighbor's houses, because there's, I don't know if you can see, there are embers flying on the neighbors. All right, this has got to be the fire station. Yeah, like it is. The guy down there is waving the fire department to the right house. Pretty sure we figured that one out there. Oh, no. Oh. Save the car! I hope everybody got out. You know, you'd say it seems to be dying out, because it's not quite as bright, but I think it's just more smoke. I can't see shit. Now the fucking fire department's here. Fucking brave guys. You know, they're moving slow, and that's only because I want the fire out now. But they've got to find a hydrant. I mean, there's a hydrant next to my house. They've probably got water on that truck. At least some. Oh, shit, I can really feel it. It's getting hot. But I think it might be hot. because the wind isn't really blowing, right? So the smoke's going up and it's not blowing the heat off. I bet you that car's got some damage, heat damage. Maybe like the tires got soft. I should get the fire money in there, huh? Now they're probably gonna shoot. Charging the hose. Yeah. They're gonna try to save the car. They ain't got enough water. They gotta find another hydrant. See, to take the fire out, what you have to do is take out the heat. There's a shitload of heat in there, so you need a crap load of water to suck that heat up and put it out. I'm gonna put this down. A little bit out there, dude. Alright, it is chilly out. It is, it's probably about 40 degrees outside. Fahrenheit for all of you Fahrenheit people. But for you Celsius folk out there, it's probably about 5 degrees out there. Maybe 6 or 7, but, It's not terribly warm. Oh man, it's like you can't even get water out of there. They gotta find the hydrant. Yeah, look at that. See the hose all bouncing out. I don't know how well you can see. Oh, okay, there we go. Put that little bit out there. There you go. That they train for. This is what we play for. It looks like I've only got 38 minutes and 56 seconds of space on the phone for this video. At 38 minutes. I'll upload it. Oh man, oh look at that. It's just, now for those of you who don't know, I learned a little bit when I was younger in fire science class. All that black smoke is actually unburnt fuel, and if that fire were actually hot enough, there'd be no smoke at all. And if you're going to say that the black is probably like the ceiling, not the ceiling, the asphalt shingles. If they have asphalt shingles, I don't know if they have asphalt shingles. Oh, this is terrible. They're our neighbors. I don't even know who they are. But you know what? I guarantee you tomorrow morning when the kids go to school, they're going to smell that. You know, you can see through the wall on the third floor there. You can see the fire on the other side of the wall. Either that or you can see it on this side and it's burning on this side, but no, it's coming through because you can see it on the above the second story left window too, which started to pop through. That's a total loss. Total loss. It was a total loss. I mean, how long does it take for a fire to become, it's a total loss? I mean, in a sense, shouldn't the fire department just kind of spray the neighboring buildings and then let it go? I mean, wouldn't it be easier?
Thank you.
I can see the roof probably better than they can, right? Only because I'm a little higher. The whole thing fixes fell off the roof and made those guys up. But there we go. So now they got a guy going up on the ladder up here. They probably got a cannon up there, right? A water cannon? He's just gonna start blasting it by the tank. Let's see what happens. You know, the side thought was like, so this is that ladder. This is like, but I mean, you know,
I'm going to go you know what? Look at that. Now that, well, it's hard to see now the smoke, but the water can is shooting out, and then the ladder goes beyond. And I said, they're not really working together, but they kind of are. I mean, what if you had to go rescue somebody? That's what would be shooting water for the person was to protect them as best you can. We'll say this, though. Part of our community here. But they have to come to the campus. Yeah, it's like, oh, wow. It'd be nice and smelly, oh, boy, I can smell that now. Yes, that's what you can't get up. Watching this at home, there, the wind shifts. I mean, I suppose you might be able to see it by watching the smoke, but even then, that's a little bit difficult to see. You know what else I just thought of? You can see, basically, this road is impassable right now, right? For good reason. We'll put the fire out. But this is Route 63. This is a state route that runs, well, it runs up to New Hampshire. If you were to take a right, where the trucks are facing, if you were to go left, you would follow 63. I believe 63 ends in North Andover when it hits 116. I go down there all the time. Oh, look at that, the shoot right up into the roof, into the attic. I wonder if they would put a guy up on that ladder, you know, like with an axe or something, kind of pound through the roof and open it up. I think they used to do that in the old days. They just put a ladder on the side of the house and climb up and start trying to tear open the roof. Thinking that you can't see too good. I thought I saw a fireman that was like on the ground and needing assistance, but I think he's sitting, basically sitting on his ass with his legs outstretched with the fire hose between his legs shooting up. So I think he's been like that for 10, 15 minutes. That's probably the best way to do it. I mean, those, I don't know if you've ever picked up a hose like that, but it throws a lot of water out. That's a lot of weight. You need a lot of weight behind it. Controller, far more weight than it would just a motor. This control is something else. It's probably real easy to control it like that. It just rinse it up and sit down, braced against the ground. I wonder how many times. I bet you Greenfield is here. Greenfield, maybe, well, if Irving came, Irving would come from the other direction. But they could have swung around. If you go to the right where the trucks are facing, there's a turn up there that can get you completely around this whole mess. A little loop around. It's the one I take the kids on. They probably have cops up there directing people around. Flare up, and these guys are going to be here for quite some time. I don't have one.